Hello guys, what is up? It's King Crystal here, and today I'm here for another video. Today, in this video, we are going to be virtually making a computer online. So, quick disclaimer before I get into the next part of the video. I'm not actually building any of this, I'm not actually buying all this or anything. This is just simply for fun and to show off on YouTube. And also, if we look at the price right here, it's around $7,100, and then after shipping and tax and all that, it would probably be around $7,200 to make this whole system. And so yeah, let's get right into it. So if I scroll down right here, our processor would be the Intel Core i7-6850K. So this is a 6-core processor, which I think is really good mid between productivity and gaming, because if you're going to game, you want lower amount of cores and like really high clock speeds on each individual core. And if you're going to be a productivity user, which is making videos and content and whatnot, you want probably a higher amount of cores and lower clock speed on each core. So this is 6 cores, which is right in the middle. And this has 3.6 gigahertz, which is also right in the middle. So that's why I think this would be a good middle ground for a processor between the productivity and gaming side of things. And also, it is the right socket type for the motherboard that we're going to use, which we'll get into later. So if we keep scrolling down, our CPU cooler is the Corsair H115i. And I don't know why that just clicked that. That just clicked change and not the actual processor, or not the actual thing, but let's click on that this time. And so this cooler uses a 280mm radiator, or two 140mm fans, which is good. I wish that Corsair made a 360mm radiator, or three 120mm fans. I think that would be really nice, but this is currently their largest radiator offering. A lot of these products are Corsair products, because I think Corsair is a good brand. And no, I'm not sponsored or anything. I'm just saying that after research, I've found that Corsair is usually good, and they last a long time. And so this would be liquid cooler, and so this would cool like really good, basically. Keep our cooler cool even under overclocking and whatnot. And so if we go back, so our thermal compound. Now the thermal compound that's pre-applied to coolers sometimes is good, but sometimes it's not. And so I'd rather just buy my own thermal compound due to the fact that it's so inexpensive and it's not hard to get. This is Arctic Silver 5. There's also Arctic Silver MX4, or Arctic MX4, which the MX4, I've heard, is better, but it doesn't last as long as this. I've heard this lasts longer, and so that's why I'd go for this one and not the MX4. But basically all this does is just aids in cooling for all the imperfections in the two metal areas. And that's about it, actually, so there's not much to say about that. Now, the next thing is the motherboard, which there's quite a lot to say about. So, the motherboard, this is the MSI Godlike Gaming Carbon X99 motherboard. So, this uses the correct socket for the processor to use, which is this thing in the middle. It has 8 RAM slots, which you guys can see right here and right here, so it would be able to house all of our RAM. Now also, if we look right here, we have 5 PCIe Express lanes, X16s, which is more than enough. You only really need maybe 3 at the most, two to three, but obviously we have more expandability with that, so not going to complain. And then we also have all like the USB headers that we need on this and whatnot. So yeah, that's why we'd get that. And it also has RGB lighting, so I could make it white lights, which is the theme of this build, black and white. So yeah, that's why that would work quite great. So now, the Corsair Vengeance LED 64GB, 4x16. Now we'd have 2 of these, meaning that you actually get 128 gigabytes of RAM. And once again, this is a Corsair product. It has, once again, white lights, because this PC build will be basically black with white lights, the whole build. And it's at cast latency 16, which 16 or 17 is the best cast latency. And then it's also at 3200 megahertz, which I think is the best RAM that's available with, like, mass production. It's harder to get 34 and 3600 with the certain RAM that you want. Alright, so next up, we're gonna go talk about storage. So the first thing of storage, this would be our boot drive. And this is the Samsung 960 Pro NVMe SSD, which connects via M.2, and says 2 terabyte right here in the picture, but believe it or not, this would actually be a 512 gigabyte. Why? Because this is just the boot drive, meaning what we install Windows onto, and we don't need much storage for that, because all this would do is basically just make your system boot up quickly, like turn on really fast, and you just don't need that much storage for that. In fact, you don't even need 512 gigabytes, you need much less. You probably only need like 8 to 16, but this is just the lowest capacity they have, so lowest capacity and cheapest. So if we press back, then, okay, we scroll down, and so now for our main storage, we'd have 3 separate solid-state drives. All these solid-state drives are 1 terabyte each, and they are solid-state drives, meaning they will run faster than normal hard drives, and they will be quieter because they don't have any, like, moving things inside them, like disks like a normal hard drive does. And so because of that, basically, quieter system, faster system, more expensive. But you guys already saw the price, so we don't need to go over that again. And yeah, I think 3 terabytes is enough for almost anybody if you're not going to be, like, saving, like, tons of different videos onto your computer and whatnot. And even if you are saving, like, a ton of videos, I think it's worth your while buying SD cards and an SD card reader and just saving all your videos on there, because videos do take up a lot of space. So next, for our video card. Now, these have not even out, really. They have just released, and you can only buy them on Newegg at this point in time. Of course, they will probably become more readily available soon. This graphics card is the MSI GTX 1080 Ti Seahawk X. This is a liquid-cooled graphics card, which sometimes, if you're not doing a custom loop, it's hard to find something like this, where it's a graphics card that's an AIO cooler in it. But these liquid-cooled graphics cards are very, very, very quiet, and they have great cooling performance compared to other graphics cards with just normal fans. And it would easily run 4K games, it would easily run 1440p and 1080p, like really easy 1080p, and you could also overclock this quite a bit. So, yep, that's why I choose that graphics card. Now for your case, this is the Corsair 780T, white. Like I said earlier, we are doing this white and black theme build, and it does come with fans in it, as you can see, but we'd take those out, and we'll get to that more later. But first of all, obviously this fits our theme for the build. Second of all, it has a fan hub built in, so if I want to install like tons of fans, which we are, you'll see later, we can use all of those. Third of all, it supports our motherboard, which is an EATX or extended ATX motherboard, which is big, so you have to have a big case to do that. And finally, it has a lot of radiator support, so it would have our cooler inside of it and our 2 liquid cool graphics cards, and it would be all good. And also, it just looks nice. So, yep, that's why we'd get this case. If I can press back. Okay. So next up, we got the power supply. Now, for the power supply, we have the Corsair AX1500i. Now, this is 1,500 watts, which, yes, is very, very, very overkill for a build like this. This build only needs a maximum 1,000 watts, which... So you're probably wondering, well, why do you want an extra 1,500 or an extra 500 watts? Well, first of all, it won't have to work as hard to get that 1,000 watts. Second of all, overclocking will be available. And third of all, this power supply has a titanium efficiency rating by 80+, which is very, very, very good. It would legitimately save you on your electricity bill to buy a high-end power supply like this with a titanium over, let's say, a gold or a bronze. Now, not all that much, but if you're going to have this system for a long time, then you want something like this that's going to get the job done and not be wasting a ton of power, not be pumping out 1,200 watts when you only need 1,000. So now we have two optical drives. Now, I've gotten comments before, and people are like, "Chris, why do you have two optical drives?" And it's as simple as, they're like, excuse me, two optical drives? You're not going to be watching two videos at the same time using optical drives. Well, optical drives are not only for watching videos, don't forget, you can do a lot of other stuff with them. And so it's just nice to have two. Although they aren't used that often today, the case does have two slots for these, and so you might as well fill them up while you can. And these are just generic LG brand, and that's about it. So, yeah, not much to say about an optical drive. Now, this is the only part that I'm including in this build that's not actually in the computer build, the operating system. Should have made that disclaimer at the beginning. This is no monitor, no monitor stand, no desk, no nothing. This is just the PC. But this is the one part that's software. And there's not really much to say about an operating system, but 64-bit, because if you're going to run a 32-bit operating system, it's just not going to be good. Windows 10 Pro, which nothing much to say. It's just a better version of Windows 10 Home, which is normal. And yeah, so keep scrolling down. All right, so this is where I was telling you guys earlier. We have a lot of system fans. So, before you guys sit there like, "Whoa, Chris, what's that?" Let me explain something. So, we'd have three 140mm Pro LED. These are all ML, magnetic levitation. So, they're going to be really silent and really efficient. They're going to have very good performance. So, one of these 140s, if we scroll up to the case... Nope, we already passed it. If we scroll up to the case... One of those 140s... I'm going to go to the picture of the case and I'll explain everything. Now, if we see right here, there's that. That's where one of the 140s would go. Now, if you recall when we looked at this liquid cooler, that also used two 140s, which would go up here. And I'd replace those gray fans that came with the AIO cooler with these nice LED white ones. Then, three more fans would go right here, which would provide an intake. And those would be three 120mm, and then two more 120mm could fit down here, which and somewhere throughout these 120mm fans, the radiator for the graphics cards would be mounted. And that's all the fans we have right there. We have three 140mm and five 120mm, so it's not actually that bad. So now, finally, we have a few custom items. First of all, we have a high bandwidth SLI bridge for $40, because if you're going to run two graphics cards, this is just something you need. So I have it open right here. There is a picture of the SLI bridge. Scroll down, you can see it is around $40 on Amazon. Second of all, we have the Elgato HD60 Pro, which is a capture card that connects through PCIe Express. And that just lets me basically screen record in very high quality and stream if I want to. And as you can see, that's about $180. Like I said. And finally, the last custom item is the NZXT internal USB hub. And so why do you need that? Well, some of the items like the power supply and the cooler can use software called Corsair Link. And they connect to the motherboard via a USB USB header. But, oh, whoops, that's the wrong thing, actually. But using a USB header. And you need more USB headers on the motherboard to connect all that stuff. So that's why we'd get that. And that's the whole PC build. So if you guys kind of know what I'm saying. Tell me what you guys think about this around $7,200 PC build because of tax and shipping and all that stuff. It would be around $7,200. I know I've done a video like this before where I showed off some components and I said stuff about them and whatnot. But the reason I took down that video was for the reason that that video was scripted, and I've really come to think about it, and I don't really like when I script videos anymore. I don't think they sound good. This whole video was done unscripted. I'm kind of just randomly saying stuff. And so because that was scripted, I thought it sounded really bad, and so I just decided to take it down and use PC Part Picker to show you guys a build that's more in-depth and better for you. So, yeah. So yeah, that's the end of the PC build, guys. I hope you really enjoyed. Comment, like, and subscribe. And if you hated the video, then dislike the video. This is King Christo signing off, and peace out, guys.